So 4th of May is just around the corner. In Halifax, excitement is building. St. John's is building. Across the country, it's building. There will be Freedom of the City parades in Halifax and Ottawa and Victoria on the 4th of May. HMCS Fredericton returning from her six-month counterpiracy mission with the Chief of Defense Staff embarked. A whole number of activities, and we're just going to build on that momentum, not just to celebrate the naval service of those who've come before, but to seize the opportunity to connect with Canadians and bring a better understanding of why the Canadian Navy matters.
Well, when I finished Canadian Naval College, I was sent to the Royal Navy as an on-loan officer. And the first ship I served in was the world's first aircraft carrier, HMS Furious. It was called the Home Fleet Carrier because it served the Home Fleet based in Scapa Flow in the Orkney Islands. And we covered the northern runs to Murmansk in Russia. We had a few battles. The Chirpitz is one of them. After that, they ran out of junior officers in Southeast Asia, and I was sent to Southeast Asia with combined operations as a naval beach officer, landing officer in Burma and Malaya.
I served on corvettes, several corvettes, minesweepers. Spent a day and a half in a submarine, and we were. Most of my career in the Navy was during the Battle of Atlantic. That is, you know, convoying merchant ships, you know, from Halifax or from New York to mid-ocean escort. During D-Day, we were designated to go with the Americans' 7th Fleet. We worked with them. We swept the channel going into Omaha Beach. My term on the minesweeper, as far as Omaha, as far as D-Day is concerned, was something to behold. To see the sky full of aircraft, 5,000 aircraft going over, no one can imagine that. No one can imagine that. And the ships as far as you could see, ship after ship behind us was hundreds.
Well, you think about the good times, you don't think about the hard times. I was on two ships that had explosions and lost a bunch of men. I was on the Nipigon and the Kootenay. I was a cook. I got off the Navy as the chief cook, chief of my bachelor's sleep. I spent 43 years and 7 months in uniform.
I think it's great to be recognized. 100 years, centennial is quite the milestone, and I think stuff like this should be done and recognized in the media to teach and to show everyone else that we're here and we're actually quite good. So 100 years, this is really exciting.
I was proud of the Navy when it was 50 years old. I was proud of it when it was 25 years old. Absolutely proud of it.